Third degree.
She would do these freaky lip Fridays.
Oh my God, people, that was the weirdest interruption ever. Like, what? So, first of all, I tend to not open the door when I'm home alone, because thus is life as a woman. So if I don't know, if I'm not expecting anyone, or if I'm not expecting like a package or anything, I just don't open the door. Like for anyone, I don't really want to say the statistic fully because it's not relaxing. But so I'm just gonna say 70%. Okay, 70%. So even if it's someone that I know, like if I see them walk up, or a lot of the time when no one opens the door immediately, people will walk to the garden to see if my dad is there. Because he's usually in the garden. So they'll walk by the window and I can see who it is. So even if it's a man that I know, I will still not go and open the door. Because 70%. But I heard voices. And female voices. So I went anyway. It's light, it's early. So I went. And it was someone that lives up the street, and they caught a worm in their garden, and they were coming to show my dad. Because they have talked about it to my dad. They have talked about it to my dad. And they said, next time if we catch one, we'll show you. So, yeah, here they are coming to show him this worm because the car is outside. And usually when the car is on the driveway, my dad is home. But I needed the car. I told you we dropped off my niece at her dad's. I may have told you that in the previous video. We dropped off my niece at her dad's today, and it was going to be very hot, and my dad's car has air conditioning, so we needed his car, so I dropped him off yesterday. So that's why the car is on. Okay, so I am going to show you this worm now. If you do not like worms, look away for a sec. It's massive. Can you see it? So it's this really big, really, really thick, bright, bright, bright green worm. And it has a really, really pointy I took video of it as well, because my sister friggin' hates all slithery creatures like snakes and worms and caterpillars. Is this a caterpillar? The lady called it a worm. So that's why I'm saying worm this whole time. But like, is that a cat? It's cat. So sorry. So I was talking to them, knowing the whole time that my teeth were gonna be blue, I know I just touch my phone and then my teeth, but I disinfect my phone like all the time. And even before this whole situation, I would never touch my phone unless my hands were clean. So when I was in class and I needed my phone for some reason, I would disinfect my hands and then take my phone, and all the students would be like, really? So, you know, if I had them use my phone, like sometimes I'd want them to take a picture of something. I can recall one time actually someone made a drawing of me with blue lipstick on the board, and I wanted a picture. I made them disinfect their hands before they touched my phone. And this was like 4 years ago. No corona, nowhere. So that is just how I live my life. So I know I just touch my phone and then my teeth, but that's fine. It's fine. Don't worry. So I knew fully well that I was talking at them with lipstick on my teeth. And so that is the thing, you know? I have a problem where I very easily get lipstick on my teeth. I don't know if it's the shape of my lips or, but I get it like a lot. And I know the tricks, and I haven't blotted yet. I usually blot and I do the finger thing. That I'm not gonna do on camera, and it doesn't help. I need the lipstick to be on for like a good half hour, and then after that half hour, enough of it will be gone in the areas that touch my teeth. And I feel with the gloss, I don't know, I feel with the gloss is gonna be a problem. With the matte lipstick, it's not a problem, it works. And with this topper, it's also not a problem. This is like a weird dry topper situation. But with this, I think it's going to be a problem. That was dry, did I not? See, it keeps getting on there. Okay, other than that though, it just kinda looks like a basic gloss. It's a bit basic. Like, I'm not getting a lot of chrome situation, but that could be because I put it over blue lipstick, and it does have that blue undertone. So that could be the problem here. It shifts between pink and blue. Pink and blue. Don't know if you can tell. So I'll have to try that one later over a different color. I'm going to put this over something dark, like a black. Put this over a black. So I need, in my fashion is black. It's not black. rest on the bottom row. On three colors, there's dust. Colors on the bottom row. And it's Please Me, which is pink. Tropic Tonic, which is coral. And Morange, which is orange. And then next to it is Relentlessly Red, which was actually gifted to me by the same friend that gave me this, but she gave me Relentlessly Red so long ago. I think it was like my second MAC lipstick or something. And I do wear that one. I love it. I actually do like Tropic Tonic, but there's something wrong with the texture. I just noticed that my mic has low battery, so I'm gonna check on it more often. I'm not using a lip liner because I'm just gonna take it off immediately. Not black black. This is black black. Seriously, it's the fourth one. This is black black. But I don't have the patience to be waiting for liquid lipstick to dry right now. I'm assuming it needs to be dry before you put on a topper. I have this as well, but I don't think it's a topper. It's like just, it's like a metallic lipstick. Like a black metallic. Yeah, it's a lip cream, it's not a top. And I've already got lipstick on my teeth. It's just my lips. It's just my lips. Okay, so this is quite poorly applied. I need to